What's up, you guys? Welcome back to your girl YouTube channel. And your girl is back with another video. Today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. It's your girl Desmalon. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and make sure you guys are tuning into this video. So today is going to be a different video. Today we are cooking. This is going to be like a little cooking vlog, you know, whatever. No, I'm not making a separate cooking channel. I just feel like, I don't know, some of you guys may want that video, and some of you guys may want to see me cook. I don't know, but I'm cooking. I just came from the grocery store and I just picked up some stuff, and I was thinking to myself, like, and one of my friends actually had mentioned to me, it was like, Destiny, like, why don't you cook and make a video? And I was like, I'll think about it. So I think long story short, I think that's what I'm gonna be doing today. Making rice pasta with shrimp and chicken. Oh my god, it sounds so good. And I didn't eat nothing all day, so you already know when I cook this, I'm about to eat so much. But instead of using like the penne noodles, I'm gonna show y'all. Y'all just gonna see everything. But today I'm gonna be cooking. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. And if you guys want more videos like this, because I do cook frequently, I do cook often, and I love cooking, and I'm always creating new things, and your girl know how to, I know how to chef it up in the kitchen. So if you guys want to see me chefing it up in the kitchen, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. And make sure you guys comment down below if you guys want to see more videos like this. So this is basically like a cooking vlog. I'm going to show y'all everything that I'm doing from beginning to end. So make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. I'm about to take all these things that I have brought. It's not really so much. It's just, as you can see, it's like two bags. Do I look fat? I have these two bags right here. I'm just about to unpack them and wipe them down, and then we're gonna get started on this video, y'all. If you guys hear any noise in the background, unnecessary noise, it's my little sister, so don't even mind that. But anyways, y'all, so I put everything away. So first things first, I'm just going to, like I said, unnecessary noise. But first things first, what I'm gonna do is, before I get started on everything, I'm going to lay out all my seasonings that I'm going to be using, and I'm gonna show y'all what I'm gonna use. So basically, I'm making rasta alfredo pasta with chicken and shrimp, but without the penne pasta that people usually use, and I use it as well. Like, I had made some rasta pasta with the penne, but this time I'm like, I don't want to use that. I want to do something different. So I have got the linguine pasta. Linguine, I think that's how you pronounce it. Yeah, I got the linguine pasta, and I got it in the brand Rosani. All my pastas, no matter what I'm making, I always get Rosani. This is my favorite brand. A lot of people say like other different type of brands, but I like this one. I'm using garlic powder, onion powder, Cajun, paprika. We have this sazon. Everything mixed. This is how it looks like. I'm gonna show y'all. Sazon, everything mixed, and I'm gonna use garlic salt, and I'm going to use obey seasoning. This is garlic and herb obey seasoning, and I always use this when I'm cooking any type of seafood, and that's gonna be for the shrimp. So I'm using this. So I think this is all the seasoning that I'm going to use. Oh, and I also didn't forget about my jerk sauce. I have my jerk sauce. I have this jerk seasoning right here. So these are the ingredients that you're going to need that I'm using today. I almost forgot to tell you guys that you need heavy cream, and this is the brand that I got, and Parmesan cheese to make our Alfredo sauce, because you know I make the Alfredo sauce from scratch. Okay, so this is my shrimp. I'm gonna show you guys. These are my shrimp. These are my jumbo shrimp. Okay, so these are the jumbo shrimp, and there, I just washed my hands and everything. Look at the shrimp. Ew, I would never do that. Basically, okay, so this is the shrimp. So the shrimp that I got, these are jumbo shrimp, and they are already peeled off on the outside, but they're not peeled off on the inside, which a lot of people like get mistaken over that. Like, when you're cooking shrimp, you're like, can you please make sure that you take the shit out? Or take the poop out. You have to take, there's like, I don't know if you guys can see, but it's like this blue line in between. That's poop. That's the shrimp poop. You have to clean it out. I just cut my chicken, and I had cleaned my chicken as well. So this is how it's looking like. They're in the bowl, they're all chopped up in a bowl. So for me to clean my chicken, I'm going to, I just use like a tablespoon of salt, and I'm going to use a fresh lime and to clean it. So a lot of people use vinegar, white vinegar, and there's nothing wrong with using white vinegar, but because I don't have white vinegar, this is what I'm using. So basically this is how it is. Just squeeze all that lime juice in there, and what that lime and what that salt is going to do is really going to clean and just take out all the germs and all that extra stuff that comes with meat, you know. So it's just gonna clean up everything. So it's really just gonna take out all the excess fat and, you know, all that other stuff from what you're doing. And it's totally fine, don't worry about it being salty or no. Is I promise you, I've been doing this for a very long time, and this is also something that I've got that was passed on for me from my mother. So basically it's really just going to clean up everything. I'm gonna add a little bit more lime. That was a small piece. Squeeze. Just going to mix that in. Gonna mix this in. Okay, y'all, so I feel like this is so much better because I'm just trying so hard to find a perfect spot to put my camera, but I think you can see everything. Yeah, I think you can see majority of the stuff. So this is my shrimp. It's sitting in the salt and sitting in the fresh lime. So I have here, and I have the chicken here. So that's just sitting down there marinating and cleaning everything that it has to clean. So like I was saying, like it's just a lot, you know what I mean? School during the day, have to wake up early in the morning, make sure I do that. Y'all who's in college, y'all already know. I don't really need to explain what the college life is. Y'all know what that's like. And midterms is coming up, then finals, and it's just a lot of things to do. So y'all know what it's like. And at work after, it's a lot of time and a lot of energy. I'm surprised I have the energy. Maybe it's because the camera is on. But other than that, I wasn't like this. I'm so tired. Now, if I wasn't making a video, truthfully, I would have been taking a nap. I would have took a nap, and then right after I would, and once I got off of my mat, I can't speak. I would have took a nap, and then I would get up from the nap and straight just doing homework. Like, that's what I do, like, when I have nothing to do now. Because I just always have something to do. Okay, ooh, y'all see my pasta water boiling? All right, so guys, I just seasoned it real quick. So this is how it's looking like. Okay, so just really quickly, I seasoned my shrimp. I already told you what I seasoned my shrimp with, right? Okay, so with the chicken, because I was on the phone. The chicken, I use onion powder. I use Cajun seasoning. I use the sazon. I use the garlic, and I use a little bit of paprika. So that's what we're going with right now. Also with the shrimp, I'm going to take my garlic, my mixed garlic, and I'm going to just add a little bit of garlic. But I'm already using, yeah, I'm going to use a little bit of garlic. This is where things get messy. We get messy, and it's just a little bit of garlic, you know, just a little bit, and that's too much. Just a little bit of garlic, just to mix in with my shrimp. Get going, and I'm gonna switch this to another thing because I want y'all to see how I make the sauce and how I fry the shrimp and everything. All right, so we're gonna cut some red and green peppers, and this is going to give our pasta some color, some flavor, some extra color, and some extra flavor. Gonna make the pasta look really nice and pretty. And like I said, this is basically like Rasta pasta. I have made Rasta pasta before, but the only difference is that I'm doing right now is that I'm using linguine pasta because I just get tired of the penne.
you know, all the time.
I want y'all to see everything.
All right, it's gonna be fine like this, guys. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with the chicken, and I'm gonna go in straight with the chicken and with the shrimp. I need some butter in the pot. Let me move this so y'all can see what I'm doing. Ooh. Just want y'all to see everything. Okay. Put some butter in the pan. Don't be shy with the butter. Straight in with the chicken. So I just second thought. Straight in with the chicken. Straight in with the shrimp. All together. Okay, get that time to cook. God, it smells so good. So I just cut up my vegetables, the red and green peppers and the onions. So okay, so now what I'm about to do is I'm about to taste one of the pasta noodles just to make sure that it's cooked, or you know, just to see if it's cooked or not. So I'm just gonna to cook. Take that out. I don't want it to be too soft. I don't like soft noodles. Everything is cooking beautifully. That color looks amazing. I'm just setting it. Take your time. Let it cook. No rush. No rush. Just let it cook. I always taste my pasta. Like, I always taste my pasta because I don't know where people be getting this theory from where you gotta stick it to the wall, and yeah, some people be sticking the pasta to the wall to see if it's really cooked. The only way where you know if something is really cooked, y'all, is by tasting it. So I taste my pasta. Alright y'all, so I'm gonna add my peppers. Wow, this looks so pretty. Didn't I tell you guys this is gonna just make it look so colorful? This is so pretty. Oh my god, like this alone right here, you guys, it's like a meal itself. You could make this with rice or some mashed potatoes on the side, some mac and cheese. Like, look at this. Yeah, see this? All right, then we're gonna add a little bit of jerk. Like a tablespoon, because jerk is very strong and I don't want a lot. So just a tablespoon of that. The color is gonna change, it's gonna get a little dark. All right, so next is our heavy cream. Gonna put the fire down low. Fire cream, heavy cream. And this is what's, this is how we're making all our Alfredo sauce. Add that. All over. Yep. Add that all over. Add this all over in the heavy cream.
A lot of people like to separate, like, you know, they like to take out the shrimp and the chicken and then do that. And then, you know, you don't have to do that. You can do that if you want to. But me, I just want everything to absorb the flavor. So that's why I like doing it in one pan. But, yeah. Add a little bit more heavy cream. I'm going to add the, I usually add the whole thing. Okay. Add the heavy cream. Heavy cream added. And we're just going to wait till it simmers. I'm gonna add a little bit more seasoning to it, add some Parmesan, and our pasta goes right in. But yeah, you guys, so while that heats up, if anybody is just like wondering like where I've been, like, you guys, I'm just doing what I have to do for myself, you know. I barely really go out as much as I used to anymore, and I feel like that's, I'm just in the zone of like, I go out here and there, but I'm just in the zone of like getting my life together and getting my things together that I know that deserve my attention and deserve my energy, such as work, making money, saving, but at the same time enjoying my money, going to school, you know what I mean, going to school, making sure everything is done, gotta, you know, chase that diploma. So, you know, there's a lot of things that I'm doing for myself that's really gonna pay off later. Okay, so for me to season it, I'm just gonna use a little bit of garlic salt, some paprika for color, onion powder, garlic powder, and some Cajun. Yeah, so that's what I'm going to use. Don't worry, you guys, it's not a lot. I know you're probably like, I don't know, it could never be too much seasoning. But I do this all the time. I make this pasta all the time, so I already know what it's gonna taste like. And these are all the things that I use anyway, so I already know what I'm doing. So the sauce looks really white on camera, but it's really not, y'all. It's like a pinkish, you know, it's getting its color. And Alfredo pat, I don't use Alfredo sauce on the pat no more, y'all. Ever since I learned how to make my own Alfredo sauce, I don't go back to the pat no more. Gonna add some Parmesan, thicken up that sauce. Pasta, we have the shrimp, we have the chicken, the parsley on top, the red peppers, the green peppers, the onions, the garlic. Whew, y'all, it looks a mess over here, but that's how it is when you cook. So I'm about to clean up everything, and I'm gonna go make myself a plate, and I'm gonna go taste it in front of you guys. But this is how it is. So let's taste this. This looks amazing. Whew. Y'all, do y'all see this? Do y'all see this? Stop playing with me. I'm still using my phone. That's why the light looks crazy. So don't worry about that. I'm about to eat now. Like, y'all can't even front. It looks good. Don't lie to yourself. You know it looks good. So, does it taste good? Let's try this. And I'm not gonna sit here. This is not a bunk bang. I'm just gonna taste it and then buy it because I like to enjoy my food. So let's taste the pasta itself. Mmm. Yeah, this is really good. Mmm. And the shrimp. Let's taste the shrimp. Mmm. Oh my god, does it taste even better than I didn't eat all day, or what's going on? Or does it really taste good? But anyways, you guys, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to this video. If you guys want to see more cooking videos or whatever y'all want to see, make sure you guys go comment down below. This tastes amazing. I'm about to eat everything. Oh my god, this is so freaking good. How can you not love pasta? But anyway, I'm about to eat. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. I love you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. If you guys enjoyed this and want more cooking videos or want me to try to make like many different things, make sure you guys comment down that below, and I'll see you guys in the next video as soon as I can. Bye.